I start my day every day at 4 o'clock in the morning. I have to come here at the station to do the sign-on program. And it is the Johnny Pusong program.
Ayon sikat an aton bida hi Johnny Pusong to.
The idea is we have to make the people happy and alive in the early morning. Typhoon Yolanda changed my work. I got jobless.
Request me ng song Gugma.
But I move on. I was changed from the traditional media and became now a humanitarian broadcaster.
Hello, Ate Ede.
On the eve of Typhoon Yolanda, I was the one on board at Radyo Diwa from 7 o'clock in the evening to 10:30 in the evening. After my program, I rushed to the house. I was afraid it was already flooded because of the very heavy rain. Luckily, we were able to run to the second floor because the whole ground floor was occupied by dark water. It almost killed us. We were lucky enough. We survived the typhoon. I said to myself, when I saw Tacloban, when I move around, I said, Tacloban, this is a dead city. Yeah, it's a dead city. No power, no communication. We stayed that way for several days. It's very hard. It's very hard. It was really necessary to have an emergency broadcast in Tacloban because there was no information at all. It was Pico John who looked for partners to provide us the equipment. And Pico John, us as survivors in Tacloban, they engaged us for this work at Radyo Abante. The name Pico John comes from Peace and Conflict Journalism Network. They are journalists for journalists. Because of the trainings that Pico John conducted on us, we were able to absorb the humanitarian way of broadcasting. We go to the communities. We get the voice of the people, the concerns of the people, and bring their voices to the humanitarian agencies and the government agencies as well. Two-way communication is very important. We set up our feedback mechanism. We have SMS lines. We have this call line. Anyone can just walk in and tell us their concern. Most of the issues that are coming from the communities are related to humanitarian response, not being given relief goods, not being given construction materials, has no relocation site, not included in the bunk house, no medicine, no money. We are the bridge. We call ourselves bridge. Once we get a concern from this community, we bring the problem to the concerned humanitarian organization or government agency for possible, resolution of that concern. Our wish is to make Radyo Abante a regular humanitarian radio station. We hope to increase the power so we can increase also our reach. But we cannot do that without partners. The partners now of Pico John are humanitarian organization. I can say that Tacloban is recovering now. I can say it's a very slow-paced one. Still, it's moving. We have not fully recovered, but maybe little by little we can do.
Dr. Johnny Pusong, Fred Padernos. Dapat salamat. Anaton mga taga-Tacloban, mga taga-Isel Samar, mga taga-Samar, Leyte, ng mga lugar na abot ng Radyo Abante. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Good night, everyone. Thank you.